So I had rum cotta, chata. It is a dairy cream rum, flavored rum. It was $21.99 for a bottle, but it's very flavorful. It's hard to say what flavors are in it. Horchata con ron. So whatever horchata is. Caribbean rum with real dairy cream, natural and artificial flavors. Oh. It's produced and bottled by agave, which is a sweetener, a natural sweetener. In Pewaukee, Wisconsin. Plus, best enjoyed within 6 months after opening. Oh, no refrigeration necessary. Pewaukee, Wisconsin. Agave. Local. Agave local brands. Orlodo, agave, I can't see. Excuse me. But I have a lot of CBD going on. CBD tincture with DMSO in it, under my tongue. The CBD freeze, or whatever it is. CBD vape oil, vape juice. Oh, it's nice. I do have hemp lotion. I don't know if it's medicinal or not. I mean, it's just sold at the salon, Moraine Park. Oh, it is out of me. I bought a box of Celestial Seasonings whole something something blackberry tea. It's not that good. I only bought one box. I couldn't find elderberry. Boy, do I like elderberry tea. It's a little tart. It adds a lot to a regular iced tea. These boxes of tagless tea bags were only $1 at Walmart. National Cup brand. Hundred tagless tea bags. Orange Pico and Pico Cut Black Tea Blend. I never saw myself that way. Thank you. The vape shop on Johnson near the laundromat place, well, a couple blocks down, had these, and they're pretty good. 500 milligrams of CBD. I paid $45 for a bottle of a different brand, but the bottle looked the same, at Hempworks, near Walgreens, on the strip mall behind Walgreens. And at the vape shop, I don't know what it's called. Chris Singleton used to own it, or he does, I don't know, he doesn't. I asked him about CBD oil, he told me about this, that it's $30, and then he said, but today it's buy one, get one. So I got $90 worth of CBD oil for $30. CBD vape juice. Don't put CBD oil in a vape unless it specifies, you know, hemp oil or anything. I did that, and it's just too thick. You need vape juice for a vape. And blah, 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 blah. Oh, my God, my God. Agave. I have this trash bag that, it's a good size, you know, but I fill it up like twice a day, this trash can. Pasteurization may not be good, as good as just not pasteurizing something, like milk, is what I mean. It's a heating process. It's not, I don't think you boil the milk, but you steam heat it or something. It's possible that non-pasteurized milk keeps better at room temperature. Oh. usually vegetable oil. And then you reheat it, or they're not supposed to. I don't know if that's trans fat. I don't really know what trans fat is. Trans. I just don't know. I don't know. It makes it toxic, though. You know, it's not good for the body. I'd break the down. It's agave, AGAVE, loco, LOCO, brands. Produced and bottled by, and it's in Pewaukee, Wisconsin. It's good with ice, you know, just poured over ice. But it's good with coffee, too. Does. God says I'm a liqueur girl. It's not as strong as, you know, vodka and rum and stuff. You can sip on it and stuff and not really get drunk, but you can get relaxed. Right, it's probably okay. Mm-hmm. Oh, I did. So if you have crusty stuff in your deviated septum, it stops your proper breathing through your nose, airflow. Rum and coffee liqueur. Mm-hmm. Oh, I don't know. I buy most of my tobacco and tubes and stuff at Windy City Cigars. It's outside of Chicago. It's in Illinois, outside of Chicago. But I buy online. This was, I think, on sale for $11.95 for a pound. And I like the hundreds tubes. They're about $2.50, $2.75 a box. I bought 10 boxes of this shipment. I bought some Muscle Milk protein powder, a big jar at Walmart for 19 or $21. And I'm going to use it to make smoothies. I got a blender at Walmart for $14.96. I haven't had a blender on my own, like, ever. Oh, her phone. Right. Mm-hmm.